Hi guys, James at Rampant Lion Reviews again for you today with another beer review. For this one, we are going to stick to Scotland and we're going to have a look at a beer from another brewery that I've never tried anything from before. Now, these guys are still fairly new to the scene, but I've just never come across their beers until now, so it's nice to finally get a review done for these guys here on the channel. So, fingers crossed this is another good beer. For this one then, we are going to head up to Peterhead in the very northeast of the country, right on the tip of the monster's nose, as I used to like to say, just because Scotland looks a bit like a monster's head. But for this review, we are going to have a look at my first beer from Brew Toon. So this one is called the Loose Cannon. It comes in at 6% ABV, and this one is a West Coast style IPA from what I understand. So yeah, very curious to see how this one turns out. I did also pick up their Red Ale, and hopefully I can have a look at one of their New England hazy type IPAs as well fairly soon. But yeah, you will definitely see the Red Ale during this cycle of Scottish beer reviews, but this is the one that I wanted to start with. As you'll know if you've watched the channel for any length of time, I'm a big fan of the West Coast IPAs, so this is the one that really caught my eye first. But like I said, very curious to see how it turns out. Fingers crossed it's another nice beer, and I'm glad that I'm finally able to review something from these guys here on the channel for you. So let's go for it. So as always with my reviews, I'll tell you a little bit about the brewery before we taste the beer. If you want to get straight to the tasting, just fast forward. All the usual links are in the video description below. That's the brewery website, the link to my other reviews that I'll do in the future from Brew Toon. Very first time I'm trying one of their beers, as I mentioned, but you will see more soon. There's all the usual social media down there. If you want to see more reviews, do please consider subscribing to the channel. The whole channel, of course, has a geography-based tagging system, so you can go into the homepage and search for beer based on country, city, state, county, province, prefecture, whatever it is that takes your fancy. Do check out the playlists of beers from different countries. There is one there for all the Scottish beers that I've reviewed for you. That's being added to quite a bit at the moment because I am enjoying a little bit of time at home in the motherland. And as always, please do get in touch and let me know some of the other beers and breweries that you guys would like to see me review. It's always great to hear from you guys that are watching the videos, and the support that you show the channel is hugely, hugely appreciated. So anyway, to tell you a little bit about Brew Toon then, on to my brewery notes. So as I've mentioned to you already, Brew Toon are based in Peterhead, in the very northeast of Scotland, right on the tip of the monster's nose. And the company was founded back in 2017 by Cameron Bowden, who used to work in the oil industry for a number of years, and apparently he also owns his own construction company as well. But he was apparently a craft beer enthusiast, and this led him down the path of home brewing, as it does for many. And after working for Acker Solutions for a few years, he got the opportunity to start his own company, and he was assisted in this by his parents Fred and Shirley. So the brewery was founded officially in May of 2017, and it can be found on Peter Street. Apparently the site that they occupy was previously a brewery and a bakery, and it was renovated and turned into a brewery and bar, and it opened in late 2017. Over the years, they've continually increased the capacity of the brewery and the infrastructure that they have in there, and the bar has continued to grow in popularity, and it's meant to be a little bit of a kind of beer hub, if you like, in Peterhead. I know that Brewdog have got a bar up there as well, and that's not too far from Ellen actually, but Peterhead is known for being, it's one of the biggest fishing towns actually in Scotland, come to think of it. So yeah, it kind of makes sense that there's a wee bit of a hub for this up there as well actually, so fingers crossed I can get up there at some point and have a look at the bar, and maybe film a little bit of an out and about video. Maybe we can even do a meet the brewer thing with Cameron. That would be pretty cool. But yeah, that's something we can definitely look at in the future once the whole COVID-19 thing buggers off. But I've never been to Peterhead at all. Never, not even when the Pars have played them, have I been up to Peterhead actually. But yeah, I used to study in Aberdeen, but just never made it up there, so that's something that I will need to see about at some point in the future. But as of December 2020, when I'm filming this review for you, these guys have produced around 25 different kinds of beer, and that number is going to continually increase, I'm sure. But yeah, that's all I can really tell you about Brew Toon for the moment. I think the name that these guys use is taken from the football team, who are, you know, Peterhead are known as the Blue Toon. And I think that's just a reference to the sea, basically, because, you know, fishing town, as I mentioned. But, yeah, so Brew Toon, I guess. Yeah, Peterhead always, Peterhead, if I remember rightly, have got quite a wealthy backer. So they've always done fairly well for quite a small team, actually. So, as I say, hopefully I can get up there at some point and have a little look at the football ground and see a game there. maybe when the Pars go back there at some point in the cup or whatever. But yeah, definitely nice, as I said, to have these guys here on the channel, and fingers crossed it's a good beer. But for the meantime, that's all I can really tell you about Brew Toon at the moment. If you want to learn more about this brewery, you can check out the brewery website, you can follow them on Facebook and Instagram to keep up to date with all the latest goings on, and you can check out the Rate Beer, Untappd and Beer Advocate pages to learn more about all the different beers that these guys have done. So yeah, let's get on and actually have a look at this beer itself then. So I looked up on the website the hops and things that were in this one. So this one is hopped with Williamette, Cascade, Liberty, Mosaic, Mount Hood and Chinook, and it's got a malt base of Maris Otter and Amber malts. So, you know, the malt base we are quite familiar with, but there are a few hops in here, I think, that are not so common. So the ones that I picked out from this that I wanted to learn a little bit more about is Liberty. So Liberty comes in at between 3 and 6% alpha acid. It's a German hop. It's derived from Hallertau. And it's often used as like an aroma complement hop, if you like, even though it's such low alpha acid. And it would, you know, if you're thinking about German style beers, the Hallertau and Tettnang hops usually sit around 5%, 4.5%, 5% alpha acid. So, yeah, this one. It's quite interesting that they use this. They use it apparently to get a little bit more kind of spice and herbal quality in these German style beers. The next one that's interesting is Mount Hood. I have had this before, but not too often again. This one comes in at between 4 and 7% alpha acid. It's an American hop developed in Oregon during the 1980s, and it's also derived from the German Hallertau. And again, it's known for its kind of spicy qualities, if you like. And then there's Williamette, which is quite popular in West Coast IPAs. It's quite a popular bittering hop, and also a little bit for aroma as well, actually. It comes in at 4 to 6% alpha acid once again. It's derived from the English Fugal hop, which is known for its kind of faggy ash type quality, but it's named Williamette after the Williamette Valley in Oregon, and it's known for its kind of spicy character and also its blackcurranty, blackberry type aromas and flavours that it can give as well, actually. So yeah, I've had quite a few West Coast IPAs with Williamette in them, so that is one that I am familiar with, but you don't come across it too often these days, especially when it comes to European beers. But yeah, the other hops in this one we know quite well. Cascade is the kind of classic first high alpha acid American hop, even though it's about 8% alpha acid, which is quite low these days. Grapefruit, a little bit, you almost get a little bit of a kind of figgy quality from Cascade, I always find. We've got Mosaic in there. Big 13, 14% alpha acid hop, lovely tangerine notes. And what's the one we've missed? Chinook. We know Chinook is a bittering hop, big piney resins and dark grapefruit as well. Some people use it as a bittering hop, some people use it as an aroma hop. But yeah, regardless, very interesting hop profile in this one. Williamette, Cascade, Liberty, Mosaic, Mount Hood and Chinook. Quite unusual, I have to say. But yeah, let's get this guy out then, and we'll get on with the tasting. Just a little quick look at the artwork for you there, which you can see the anchor, obviously, referring to you know, the kind of seafaring heritage of the town, if you like. And there you can see that's also on the bottle cap, which is pretty cool. It says on the side here, our American IPA is fully loaded with a juggernaut of hops that will send earthquakes crashing through your taste buds. Its strong floral and herbal aromas and sharp grapefruit notes are well balanced by its rich malt base. Its finish is edgy and uncompromising and leaves for an expressive, almost spicy palate. This IPA is a loose cannon, 6% ABV. So, yeah, pretty cool, actually. So, yeah, this should be pretty nice. So, like I said, 6% ABV, this one. Let's get it out and get on with the tasting then. Quite curious to see what this one has in store for us. I'll need to keep this bottle cap as well, because I don't have one from Brew Toon. But nice little bit of smoke on the opening there, and we'll get it out and into the glass. So there we go. This should be pretty nice, actually. It looks good. Been wanting to try these ones for a long time, actually, but like I said, you guys will know, if you've watched the channel before, I love a good West Coast IPA, so this one caught my eye, and the Red Ale as well. Always enjoyed a good Red Ale, so these were the two beers that I wanted to try from these guys first. But there you go. So, wee bit of sediment in this one. I must have had the fridge just a little bit cold, actually. I've been wondering about that in a few of the last reviews. But yeah, there is a fair wee touch of sediment floating around in this one. Is it maybe bottle conditioned? No, it doesn't look like it. Not too much in the way of sediment on the bottom of the bottle there, so maybe I've just had the fridge a wee bit too cold actually. I'll need to adjust that. But yeah, as you can see with this one, it's poured a lovely kind of rich blood orangey amber. You can see that when we poured the beer, there was about a quarter finger of a frothy, I would say slightly cream coloured head on this one, but it's fading away to just be a very thin foamy layer, although there is a fairly impressive foamy ring around the edge of the glass. It's lovely and thin and wispy on top now. One or two big bubbles sticking towards the side of the glass, a few little ones going up towards the surface there, but yeah, otherwise it looks pretty smooth. There's a nice kind of, there is a nice little bit of just sediment going around in that. It's all natural, of course, but it looks pretty nice. As you can see, if I put my fingers behind the glass here, it does have a little bit of natural haze to it, which kind of is what you would expect from a more West Coasty type IPA. But yeah, really looking forward to this one. Let's take a closer look at the aroma and see how we go. Ooh, yeah. This does smell pretty classic, actually. You know, straight away from this one, you get the malt qualities out of it. And as I've told you on the channel numerous times, I love a little bit of a kind of sweet backbone to these IPAs. That's why I love the West Coast IPAs so much. It's probably that Scottish sweet tooth that I always talk about. But yeah, straight away with this one, you can smell the Maris Otter. It's the Maris Otter that really stands out with this one. It's just got such a distinctive aroma. You get a little bit of a kind of mix of kind of white bread and sort of wholemealy bread. That forms the backbone of the beer. You get a wee bit of a kind of sweet caramelly note to it, but you've also got a little bit of that almost McVitie's digestive like biscuit quality coming out of this one. Those are the three components of your malt base in this one. The amber malt will probably be contributing to that as well, but for me, the malt base of this one, it's Maris Otter all the way. It really takes the lead. So I'm not sure if the amber malt is being used as the base malt. I mean, I would guess that probably they're using a bit of pale malt in this one as the kind of base malt, then the other two are the kind of supplementary malts. Quite a few breweries these days don't mention the fact that they use pale malts, because that is such a common base malt. But we'll see, I'm sure we'll be able to tell from the actual flavour of this one. But, you know, the Maris Otter sticks out a mile away on this one, and it's a beautiful malt. It is a lovely, lovely malt, English malt. So yeah, lovely kind of sweet biscuity notes out of this one. McVitie's Digestives, like I said, bit of a straight up sweet caramel on there. Maybe a wee bit of that kind of Werther's Original type thing. There's a wee bit of that almost kind of butter candy out of this one. Kind of white brown bread underneath. But to be honest with you, I think that covers the malt base quite nicely in this one. On the hoppy side of things then, I tell you something, you certainly get a good wee bit of kind of floral spicy notes out of this one. And that'll be all those hops that we mentioned, the Mount Hood, the Liberty, and I guess the Williamette as well. You really get quite a bit of that out of this beer. There is a wee touch of earthiness in this one. You know, you get a wee bit of earthiness out of this one, but you get quite a spicy floral aromaticity out of it, which is really interesting. It's not mad and kind of in your face, but it's almost like a kind of subtle spice in a lot of ways. I really like how that goes together in this one. But yeah, you've also got a nice kind of grassy component to this beer as well. But I would say when it comes to the green side of this beer, it's quite, you know, it really is quite big and floral and spicy. I do like how that goes together in this beer. So yeah, the green component of this one is quite interesting. I think this beer is going to have a fair whack of bitterness to it just on the basis of the aroma. And I think, you know, that's one thing I really do miss about the West Coast IPAs is the big bitterness that they always used to have. So yeah, high hopes for this one, I have to say. It's got the sweet malt that I like. It seems to go, that it's going to have a bit of the bitterness to it. So yeah, let's take a quick look at the fruity side of things. So yeah, I have to say, the sort of green component of this beer is quite powerful, actually. So this one smells as if it's going to be a properly old school West Coast IPA, which is what I want. I don't want one that's got this kind of lower bitterness that a lot of the new ones have. Definitely not. I want an old school West Coast IPA. But what you'll notice with this beer, on the fruity side of things, it's definitely got a nice kind of tangerine orangey note from the Mosaic. You get that straight away in this one. You can smell a little bit of the stronger grapefruit from the Chinook. I guess one thing that will also be contributing to the sort of spiciness that this beer has will be the Chinook, but I've always found Chinook is more piney and resinous, and I don't get so much of that out of this one, but probably that will come out a little bit more in the aroma. It depends, of course, when, at which point during the boil they've added the hops, and we'll talk about that later. But yeah, the aroma of the fruits in this one is quite distinctive. Good little bit of darker grapefruit. You get a wee bit of that juicier, kind of almost slightly figgy grape, but still oily grapefruit and juicy grapefruit, but it's almost a little bit figgy as well. You can smell the Cascade. The Cascade, I think, is a really, really distinctive hop, especially for me, because one of the beers that I really got into back in the day was the Schiehallion from Harveston, which is a Cascade Czech-style pilsner, basically. But yeah, you get those kind of things in with this beer. You can smell the Cascade right away, and you can also smell that big, juicy, kind of tangerine note from the mosaic in this one as well. So yeah, the aromas in this beer are very, very old school, and I think there's a sort of antagonistic thing going on between the brown sugars in this beer and the sort of tangerine oranges, actually. So I've got a feeling that this one is going to be right up my street. But take a little bit of time and enjoy the aroma of it. It looks the part, it smells the part of a West Coast IPA. I do have high hopes for this one. So enjoy that first. As always say, that's half the experience with craft beer. We are going to get stuck into this one. This is the Loose Cannon 6% West Coast IPA from Brew Toon in Peterhead in the northeast of Scotland. Let's get stuck in. Slange, skull. Oh yeah, that's quite nice actually. Yeah, it is pretty good actually. This is in pretty good condition as well, to be honest. Yeah, where to start with this one? It's got what I would want from a West Coast IPA, I'll say that. It does have a wee bit of an English IPA character to it as well though, from the malty side of things, the amber malt, I think. It really has a wee bit of a kind of wholemeal, brown bready graininess to it, this beer. So yeah, that makes sense in this one. Yeah, this definitely has a wee bit of an English type character to it as well. So yeah. But it's certainly got the sweet malty backbone and the more kind of spicy floral aromatic thing going on with it as well, which I really like. So yeah, thumbs up to Brew Toon for this. This is a solid effort actually. Yeah, we'd love to try this fresh on tap at the brewery. That would be the next thing. Would be to have one of these at the brewery and see how it is. But yeah, I like this one. This is a little bit more old school, and it really does have a big green component to it, this one, which is quite nice. So yeah, let's kind of break the flavour of this one down a little bit more then. Yeah, so straight away with this beer then, you can feel that nice kind of bready quality that just blankets the middle of your palate. It's quite a brown, sort of wholemealy, bready sort of thing. And as you go in the middle third of your palate, it's got a nice kind of smoothness to it. But as you go onto the back third of your palate, there's definitely more of a kind of grainy sort of thing coming out of it. Definitely a grainy, sort of brown, bready type vibe out of the beer. So yeah, it's definitely got a little bit more bitterness and spiciness almost from the grains on that back third of your palate. I really do suspect that is the kind of amber malt in this one actually. But yeah, in the middle third of your palate, it's, as I say, it's definitely a little bit smoother. If you go towards the middle of your tongue, you can feel right in the centre of your palate. It's got a sort of oily circle, if you like, a more kind of sweet caramelly sort of thing. And as you move out from the centre of your palate towards the edges, that's when you get a little bit more of the kind of McVitie's digestive sort of thing. So yeah, the malt base in this one has a wee bit, the graininess that you get has a wee bit more of that kind of English IPA sort of vibe to it. So it's kind of interesting, a little bit of an almost ode, if you like, to the kind of classic IPAs, if you kind of want to look at it that way. But yeah, the colour of the beer is quite interesting as well. I guess quite a lot of that is derived from the amber malts, if you like. Your colour's dependent on two things. One, the type of malts you use. Two, the length of the boil. Most IPAs like this will have a 90-minute boil. The longer that you boil these beers, of course, the more the sugars caramelise, thus the darker the colour will come out of the beer. So, yeah. So, yeah. The way that this one goes together is I like the malty side of it. You guys know I'm a sucker for a malt base, so I always like to give that proper focus. But let's move on to the hoppy side of things with this beer then. So in the back corners of the palate, you do get a wee touch of earthiness out of this one. These kind of more, you know, the Willamette, the Liberty, the Mount Hood, I'm sure are all going to contribute to the kind of earthiness that this beer has, but the Mosaic will too. So there is a fair wee earthy component to this beer in the back corners of the palate, but as you move further forward, there is a wee bit of herbal quality there in front of the earthiness. Then as you reach the kind of front corners of the palate, there's a nice big, there is a nice big kind of piney resin quality underneath. You can feel that there. That's the Chinook giving you that. And then on top of that, you've got quite a spicy character from, you know, the Mount Hood and the Liberty. So that's quite an interesting one. That would indicate that those hops, you know, the Liberty and the Mount Hood, I think, and probably the Chinook, have been used as early edition hops. You know, when you add hops earlier in the boil, they give you more of their kind of spicy, bitter type component. But then if you add them on later on in the boil, you've gradually got a trade-off between, you know, the bitterness contribution and then the flavour and aroma contribution as you go through the boil. And I think that's what's going on here. I think those two hops have probably been added a little bit earlier on in the boil, if you like. Chinook could well be the bittering hop in this one, because it's got a really piney resinous quality to it, that one. It really sits there. But round the front curve of the palate, you've got a bit of a lighter sort of grassy kind of thing going on, but it's the, you know, it's the floral aromaticity and the piney resins that really linger there in this beer for sure. So yeah, green component of this beer is quite nice. It's really smooth on the front curve of the palate actually, but then quite spicy and floral and things on the sides. But yeah, I think that sums it up quite nicely, this one. So there's a good contrast there between the malt and the hoppy side of things. On the front third of your palate though, that's where you get that nice oily bubble where those juicy fruity esters just roll their way out of the beer. This one has that nice big oily feel to it that you would expect from a West Coast IPA. So if you go towards the back of that front third of your palate, you definitely get a wee bit of that darker grapefruity note. That'll be coming mainly, I think, from the Chinook, just because of the sheer pungency of it. But then as you move further forward, you can feel it sort of mellows out a little bit, and that's when you get the slightly more juicy, oily kind of cascady notes. So you can feel that as you go further forward in this one, and I think probably the Willamette will be contributing to that as well, because as you reach the kind of front half of that front third of your tongue, the front sixth if you want to go that way, you get that more oily kind of tangerine note from the Mosaic, and then underneath you've got a sort of you can pick up the more kind of blackcurranty, sort of blackberry-ish type qualities from the Willamette in there as well. Willamette's got a really interesting vibe about it. It's yeah. I remember one of the other things that quite a lot of breweries do with these kind of beers is put a little bit of a kind of plum sugary sort of thing in them, just to give the beer just a wee tiny component of that figgy kind of red fruity sort of thing. It's almost similar to what you get from Cascade in a lot of ways, and I'm definitely picking up a wee bit of that vibe here. This beer, as you go further into the aftertaste, there is almost just a very slightly figgy, plummy type thing comes out of it. But behind that, you've got the oily tangerine oranges and other things, that strong kind of grapefruity quality. It's just a nice beer, this one. It's quite a classic West Coast IPA, but with a slightly more kind of English malt base to it. I think that sums it up quite nicely. The fruits have that big oily quality to it. It brings out the orange, it brings out the more kind of oily aspects of the Cascade and the Willamette as well there. So a bit of fig, a bit of a kind of blackcurranty. I would be more tempted to say blackcurrants. Blackcurrants are more oily, more juicy if you like, whereas the blackberry is a bit brighter and tartar almost, if that makes sense. So yeah, the fruity side of this beer is quite interesting and quite classic in a lot of ways too. So as a West Coast IPA, this one definitely gets a thumbs up from me. I don't think this is at its absolute freshest. I think it's kind of getting towards the end of its prime, in fairness. There's just a few wee hints in there that kind of give me that vibe, but it goes down very nicely, let's just say that. So let's look at the mouthfeel then to round off the review. It's got I would describe this one as being at the bottom end of full-bodied, kind of top-end and mid-bodied. It's somewhere in that kind of region. The carbonation's really smooth. The mouthfeel overall comes across as quite oily, but at the same time, it's got that typical kind of Scottish cleanliness to it. You know, the quality of the tap water we have. We're always very proud of our tap water in Scotland. But yeah, the bitterness, I think this one's got to be about 70 IBUs, maybe a little bit more, 70 or 80. This one does have the kind of classic bitterness to it that you want from one of these West Coast IPAs. They're certainly not skimping out on the IBUs in this beer, which I'm very happy about. The malt base, like I say, has a wee bit of a grainy component to it. That builds into the aftertaste as well. You get a wee bit of graininess to the beer, but you've also got a smoothness and a kind of more oily, brown sugary sweetness in there as well. And you've also got those kind of big oily, but still quite juicy, fruity characters coming out of the beer too. But yeah, this one I really have quite enjoyed, actually. I'd love to try it fresh at the brewery and see what it's like straight out the tap, because I think it would be even more oily than it is. But yeah, this is a solid West Coast IPA, and it certainly makes me curious to try the red ale that I've got in my box. So yeah, curious to see what that one has in store for us. But this one was a very, very nice beer, I have to say. So thumbs up to Brew Toon for this one. This definitely makes me curious to try some of their other things. So yeah, I guess I'll need to have a go at something dark, a lager, and maybe one of the hazy IPAs as well. Those will have to be the next things after the red ale. But yeah, I definitely will pick up a few more from these guys the next time I make it home. So yeah, this has been a very nice beer to introduce Brew Toon here on the channel. So I hope that you guys have enjoyed my take on this one, impressed with this. So yeah, fingers crossed we can go up and have a little look at their pub sometime as well. So yeah, this one was the Loose Cannon, a 6% West Coast style IPA. Has everything you would want from the style, and I think this is really damn solid. So yeah, if you get the chance to try some of their beers, have a go at them. So yeah, let's leave it there. Once again, thank you for watching my reviews. Until the next time, please like, subscribe, share, all the usual YouTube stuff. Let me know your own thoughts on this beer in the comment section below. Let me know what your favourite beers are from Brew Toon as well. We will return to these guys fairly soon for the radio, and beyond that, I'm sure we will do more reviews quite soon too. But yeah, thank you again for watching, and I will catch you guys very soon. Until the next time, slange and snow. Make sure you check out Brew Toon, check out my social media, and I will catch you guys on the next review. Slange, skull, cheers, and catch you guys later.